Okay, everybody. Hey, how's it going? This is Rock Paper Mario, and this is Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. This is actually my 100th video on this channel, which is kind of interesting, and I wanted this to be a really kind of happy celebratory occasion. Oh, you can just go away. I'm really not in the humor for you guys right now. Basically, one of these rocks has a hole under it, and I don't know which one it is, so I'm gonna have to just wander around blindly. I bet you it's one of the small ones. That's just the kind of crap they do, where they put it like under one of the small ones, because you think it's gonna be under one of the big ones. Oh, well, there it is. It was under one of the big ones. Oh, will you go? I scratch my nose, and you just smash me in the face with that pork. Pork? Fork. Pitchfork. Yeah, I'm not in the best of humor today. I'm just... Unfortunately, I wanted to be in the best of humor because I wanted this celebratory, like, 100 video to be just a way of saying thanks to you guys and of expressing how much I appreciate just all the support you've given me. But I don't know, like, yesterday, I don't know if you know, if you guys know this, anyone in the UK and anyone in Ireland will know this. But I don't know about anyone else. Basically, yesterday was the day where, here in Ireland, the IMF and the EU Central Bank, arrived in order to basically bail out our country. Now that may sound like a good thing, but it's not really. I mean, firstly, there's the fact that we have to be bailed out, which is a terrible thing, and it's absolutely awful. But there's something much more than that. I mean, if you're being bailed out by the IMF, if your country is, then that basically means that your country is no longer in control of its own affairs, which is quite sad in my opinion. And I think, I don't know, like, I could have cried yesterday. I really could. I could have gone home yesterday morning and just cried. It's just so sad. I don't know, like, to think that for generations and generations people gave their lives and fought and struggled, young people, young men, young women, struggled to make Ireland an independent state and to make us have the ability and the privilege to be able to control our own destiny and to be a sovereign independent state. And that, because of the just unforgivable greed and just ridiculousness of the past decade, has just been submitted and abandoned. And that just, it makes me so sad to think of that. I mean, it really does. I mean, I don't know, it's kind of hard to explain, really. It's just, it's like, I don't know if you guys know basically how big a problem we have here. Basically, there are people here that are just absolutely at the end of their tethers, basically, as far as money is concerned. We have, basically, in a country that has a population of 4.5 million, we have over 450,000 unemployed. And that's not even counting the people that aren't counted as unemployed because they're in education or whatever, or because they're disabled, or because they're retired and on a pension. So it's actually a lot more than that that aren't in employment at the moment. And I'm sorry for dumping all this on you guys. I promise I won't anymore, because Let's Playing has always been and will always be and should always be a place where people can escape from the grim realities of life. But I just had to, because I had to just offload all these negative feelings on somebody, so I'm sorry that you guys had to be the ones to get it. But I don't think I could speak so candidly to anyone else other than no one. I don't know. It's just so, it's like, this is meant to be the video where I say, I can't believe that it's 100 videos, and I can't believe that I'm here, and that I'm still here, and that I'm getting so much support from all you guys that I appreciate so much, and unfortunately, I'm just not in that sort of humor today. Don't worry, this is going to be the only... I promise I'll, like, lighten up for the next few videos. This is going to be the only video where I behave in this manner, so don't worry. But basically, as I was saying, we have just absolutely abominable unemployment here in this country. We have a suicide epidemic that is basically hemorrhaging our nation. It is absolutely just despicable. And the wind is not facing the wrong direction. Or the wind is facing the wrong direction. And it is just so... Like, I'd like to say there's a fire outside and it's raging, but there isn't. Far from being incensed and angered at these events, we are, in fact, the Irish nation as a whole, and we as a nation on a whole, are a nation of the depressed. We are a nation that just doesn't see that there's any point in fighting anymore, that there's no point in even trying, and that kind of... that fear and apathy and distrust has poisoned and pervaded our entire population. And I'm not even concentrating on what I'm doing here, sorry now, but I... And we have... Like, this is ridiculous. We have basically a government that has not so far made... In the last 2 years of this economic crisis... have not made an official address to the public. And I just think, how despicable is that? I mean, how just wrong is that, that we have an elected government that can't even address its own public? And just... It's just too much to put into words. I just can't. It's just wrong, really, is what it is. You have the Master Sword. That sword shall shine in the darkness, casting back evil. Within your hands, none can keep you from rescuing your sister. Do not be afraid. Well, there's a reason why I'm telling you guys all this. I know that most of you guys... Well, first of all, most of you guys are a lot younger than I am. And... probably don't understand what's going on. Don't really... you may not even care, I don't know. But I don't want... Basically, I grew up in a generation where nobody cared about anyone else, where nobody stood up for what they believed in. And I don't want you guys to grow up that way. I don't know, I feel that it's my responsibility. And there's no word for it in English, but there's a word in the German language called Zivilcourage, which basically translates as the courage or the will to stand up for your own beliefs and to stand up against wrongdoing. And that's something that has been sorely absent that's an ethos that has been sorely absent from our community in this past decade and over a decade. I mean, we were a population who basically, as long as one was all right, then that doesn't matter. You don't care about anybody else, which is the wrong way to feel about anybody. And I don't want you guys to grow up thinking that same way. I want you guys, if you see something that you don't agree with and that is against your personal beliefs and I want you to stand up against it and say, no, that's wrong. I don't, like... Because it's important. This spirit of civil courage is just one of the most important things we have as human beings. And to lose that would be just... It would be a tragedy. It would be an absolute misery upon our race, really. And I really don't know what to say. I'm only up to 10 minutes here. But I kind of want to end the video because I don't see... There's kind of some fun stuff going up... Coming up in like the next minute or so. And I don't want to go into that on this bum note. I want to leave just this video... On its own. As the video where I make the... Where I do what there hasn't been in here in this past 2 years, where I make a State of the Nation address. Not that any of you will care, because it's not most of you, it's not your nation. But just be known that yesterday, Thursday the 18th of November, is the day when Ireland lost independence. And the independence that was fought for generations, for centuries, by young men, young women who believed in what was right, and who believed not in saving their own skins, who believed in providing for a public, who believed in creating justice for a public in this country. And that was lost, and that was abandoned, and that was given up by there's not even words that I can use to describe just the hatred with which I hold our political system at the moment. Because there is absolutely no way to stop this bailout, to stop this, to stop the IMF and the ECB having to come in, because our country was let by our government get into such a bad state of affairs by just ridiculous and, I don't know, ridiculously irresponsible actions on the part of our banking system and on the part of our government. And it's to think that we have lost our economic independence just because of that, because of greed and because of irresponsibility and because of a lack of civil courage, is something which is a misery and which is a real tragedy. So I don't want you guys to ignore this. I want you guys to use this to forge a new spirit of standing up for what one believes in. Well, on a brighter note, thanks Vermillion for 100 videos, everybody. If you told me 3 months ago that I was going to be here in November with 100 videos, I'd have laughed, because I wouldn't have believed that I'd have had the guts to carry on. But it's you guys that have given me that strength, that have given me the will to carry on with this project. And as I said, Let's Playing is a special thing. We are a community that is immune from the grim and the harsh realities of life, and we are a community that will always stand by each other, and who will always help one another to get through whatever troubles one may be experiencing. And that's what it should be, and that's the way it should be. Everyone needs a safe haven, and that's what Let's Playing has always been and will always be for a lot of people. So I'd like to thank you guys again, and I'll see you for a much more uplifting part of The Legend of Zelda: The Wind Waker next time. Thanks a lot, everyone.